Hello world, welcome to this TU Delft online course on Dutch urbanism. We are here in the Netherlands, a European country on the coast of the North Sea, right between the UK and Germany. This MOOC is about our tradition of planning and designing for the public good. And this tradition stems from one basic historic fact, and that is that much of our country lies below sea level, as you can see here in this historic atlas. Much of what is green here is actually up to 4 or 5 meters below sea level. Now this means that we have to shape, design, mold our country in order for us to live here. We have to safeguard this public good, safety from flooding. Now the Netherlands may not float, but it's easy for you to understand that for us it's very important that we do not drown. Now this basic historic fact has led to a great collection of design, planning and engineering feats. The Dutch have constructed hundreds of polders which lie below sea level. It is this land reclaimed, and we build them so that we can live and work here safely. And the same goes for our cities. As you can see in this example, our capital city, Amsterdam. Now it is very clear that its world-famous canals are the main structuring element of the city. And they are as much beautiful as they are functional. And they stand in this same tradition of water management. Now partly because of this tradition, the Netherlands was also one of the pioneering countries for our profession, urbanism. And just one example of that is this, the general extension plan of Amsterdam drawn up by Cornelis van Eesteren in 1934. And you see here in red, modern planning and design principles that were experimented with on this large scale for the first time. If you look at the form and the structure of the city of Amsterdam as it is today, you can still recognize these shapes. Cornelis van Eesteren, by the way, who was the first professor of urbanism here at our faculty. Now this MOOC is not about water management or about the famous Dutch architects and urbanists. It's about planning and design for the public good. And we can do that for any public good. It's a way of thinking. And we're going to practice with three basic principles which we think are central to our profession. First, that there is a balance between research and design, as you can see here in this student project, in which an interpretation of the city of Haarlem was given on the basis of a research, a formal and historic analysis of the city. This balance between research and design is always there. A second important principle is that we think and work on multiple scale levels, from the region to the design and detailing of public space. And when a design is good, these scale levels corresponding, as you can see here in this final project. And the third and maybe most important principle is that we never see a design outside of its physical context. Now we are eager to acquaint you with these principles, and we are eager to learn from your experiences too. So welcome to this MOOC, and please join us in the next 7 weeks.